What's your kind of feelings about Toulon? I guess what you know about them, and what are you expecting from them? Because obviously they're
a big team now. I suppose when the super clubs now, they've got a massive squad. Probably a bit like the Ospreys are with in Wales, really. What we've seen of them, they're obviously a class outfit. We say big squads, doing well in the French league. But it's just a one-off game, and we've got nothing really to lose. All we can do is go there and give it our best crack, really, and see what happens.
Why do the Scarlets like Europe so much? You've been there, you've had some big wins as a player with this team, and that's the likes of what is it?
I don't know. When I came here, they always targeted Europe. It was something that they got really excited for, and obviously when I come from Ebervale, obviously I hadn't really tasted any of that. It was just something that they'd done well in the past, and it was an aura around it. It was just a big stage where everybody in Europe's watching you. And it just was a chance to get in the limelight a bit. But it's something they definitely always targeted. And in the past, we've always done well at it.
Could history be a bit of a burden for this team, or is it something to aspire to?
I think it's something to aspire to. You can't really have that hanging over you. I think it's something to aspire to, emulate the past, really, and trying to go one better than what we have done previously. We missed out this year. We've got a chance again this week now to try and progress a little bit further, and it's also the character at the end of it, the Heineken Cup spot, which we're battling for in the league as well. So, this game and the Cardiff game is two huge games for us, really.
How do you take on a French side on their own patch? It's such a great trek. What are you
going to
do?
I don't know. I need help on that. It's the old adage, really. It's going to start all up front, really, isn't it? They love the set piece and the scrum, line out, driver mauls. I think if you can sort of match them in that area, we're going to back a chance, and hopefully then we can get class players in Steve and Regan, John Davis, and hopefully do a bit of damage against them. But I think it's going to start and finish up front, really. Well, we've seen them on video. They're a big mauling team and got quite a big scrum as well. So it's gonna be quite a hard day, I think.
You know what's coming when you play a French team like that, don't you?
Yeah. They're usually pretty tough to be fit in. They always seem to bring on somebody bigger just after half time. It's always hard against the French. They've always got massive scrums. Love the driving lineouts, mauling. So I was trying to explain to some of the youngsters that you really got to be on your wits end, really, to get any change out of them.
Is there a different sort of physical challenge now from when you first started going to France? I mean, you don't quite have the gunslingers anymore, do you?
No, it's
a difficult physical challenge.
We do, but we still got a lot of class youngsters in the side. Whereas in the past, you had people. I suppose like Quinnell and stuff, but now we've got Dave Lyons, and we've still got players there that have played in big games and can match them. I think the French are still, they're still the same. They still have a huge mentality and a passion for that. They pride themselves on the big match room, the big scrum, and everything else that goes with that, really.
I suppose occasions like this, and they make it all worthwhile, like you say, those Tuesday nights, and going down the south of France and playing a team next morning.
Yeah, it's just this, to be in the Heineken Cup would be even better, but you're still, I suppose, in the limelight. Yeah, and it's nice to be involved in big games like this.
Yeah. What would be the message to the younger players then? Obviously, they've got a reputation as a hostile environment, big atmosphere. What do you tell the younger boys going out there?
When I first joined Ebervale, I had people like Mark Jones in the side that obviously he didn't care for a lot of people. So I think you just got to take a little bit of that attitude with you. You just really can't, not to swear, but you can't take a backward step, and you just got to play your own game and really rip into them. You can't just stand off them and let the game come to you, because you know, they've got the capability of ripping you to pieces.
What was the fear the factor for the second thing? Or was it just a change of mentality?
I think it's a change of mentality. I think you've got a lot of pride on you. You know, you've obviously been humiliated, losing by that many points. A lot of pride comes back into it then. And it was quite a... Ebbervale was quite a difficult place to play as well. It wasn't the nicest of places.
You wouldn't have liked to play there? No.
I think it was quite over the... It was the November period as well. It was quite cold up there as well. I can remember there's... You literally get all the seasons in one day up there, wouldn't you? Snowing, wind.
Johnny Wilkinson, a player you know well, how important is he for them and how dangerous is he for you guys in terms of the penalty machine?
Oh, he's a world-class player and he's proven that over the years. I think he's hugely instrumental to them. Everything comes off the back of him. You know you can't give a penalty away because his strike rate is phenomenal, really. He'll hit him over from British anyway. And drop goals as well. He's going to be a key member, keeping in their team, really. So I suppose we're going to have to be wary of him, mark him, and try and put him off his game as best we can, really.
Because discipline is going to be crucial, isn't it? And your area, the scrum's been right in the news in the last since the Six Nations, isn't it? So many collapses.
Yeah, so many penalties getting given away, really. Hopefully we, touch wood, we won't give away too many. But like I say, they've got quite a big scrum mentality, so. We can have our work cut out out there, but hopefully we can come away with a good performance.
Best moment in Europe?
I think probably beating Toulouse away the year that we got the semi-final. Mm-hmm. To come behind, from behind like we did, I think that's probably the best.